Hi everyone, welcome to Tirefly Designs. This is a video where we're going to be sharing Halloween card number 4. I'm getting some new goodies. I'm going to share my Halloween haul that I got from a mixture of sites, and I didn't get everything yet, so I will share my Halloween haul soon. And I pulled out some of my goodies from last year from Whimsy Stamps, and we're going to make a very cute card. So I hope you guys like. Here we go. So we're starting with this die from, like I said, Whimsy Stamps. It's called Slimline Hill House Die. And when I saw this die, I fell in love with it. I purchased it immediately. And I just love the seam. So I cut it in some black card set. I actually cut it 3 times, but I ended up using only 2 layers because the cardstock was so thick. And I'm also using some watercolor cardstock with it. So I cut our image out, and I'm just going to add some yellow cardstock in the windows and doors and cracks or whatever of the house. And I'm just cutting little pieces of yellow cardstock. I don't know why I cut them in pieces like that, when I could have just cut a long narrow piece for that area. But wasn't thinking at the time. So I'm putting all my windows to have lights. Next we have a piece of Tim Holtz watercolor cardstock, and we're using some of our Distress inks. We have Rusty Concord, we have Bold Lawn, Mustard Seed, and Cough Pumpkin. And we're going to just put the colors together and see what we like. Thank you. So I usually just put colors together and just keep going until it's blended the way I want it to blend. I also use another piece of watercolor cardstock and colored a piece for a little pavement or a little walkway in the scene. So I'm starting using the same colors and just I want to come up with a dark color, but not as dark as our black cardstock, so it can still stand out. So I'm just dumping colors together to see what I like. So now we have the color piece for the back of our house, our scene behind the house, and our walkway. Once we're happy with our scene, we're going to add, I'm just dropping some water in my hand and just sprinkle it over the color. And I love to see this work. Look at that, all the beauty just comes out. So this is what it looks like. I adhere my house over my color and just cut off the excess cardstock. And this little die set from Impression Obsession. What is it called? Halloween Hill. And I just used a couple of the things from the die. And I also use this stamp set from Whimsy. And that's my sweet psycho friend. What is the name of the stamp set? Cute but Psycho. I loved it. I used her last year in another Halloween card. And I love her so much. So we stamped her with some Memento Tuxedo Black ink, and we're using our Copic markers to color her up. And then, as usual, I'm going to do some fussy cutting. You're going to see by the end of the card that I changed the color of her pants. I thought it was clashing with the color of her skin and some of the orange color in the back. So I actually changed her pants to green and her bows, her little scrunchie in her head. Her little scrunchies on her hair. So once I'm done with her, I add my card to a slimline black card base. And as you can see, I colored a piece of cardstock for the inside and stamped my psycho friend again. And this time she's standing at the edge of her walkway. I think she's guarding it. And she's waiting there with her weapon for any ghosts or goblins or whomever comes by. And she's going to take care of it. She is so cute. She's like one of my favorite images for Halloween. I don't think I would ever get rid of her. She's going to fool you. Because in one hand, she's holding her teddy bear. And in the other hand, she's holding her weapon. I hope you guys enjoyed this one. Thank you for watching, and I hope you guys will come back and see my next card. Don't forget to subscribe and leave me a comment down below as to how you like this one. And again, thanks for watching. Bye.